Hey, what's up guys, Pablo Munoz here. Welcome back to another quick video tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to create an outline for a comic style render all within ZBrush and without relying on the comic style shader. Let's go ahead and jump straight into it. All right, so here we are in ZBrush and this is the model that I'm going to be using. And this outline that you see around the model or around the silhouette of the model, that's where we're going to be recreating today. So if I rotate around, you'll see we have a nice outline following the model. Let me go ahead and bring in the material palette. So I'm going to click on the material palette, click on this icon, drop it to the left. And I'm using the comic style shader material that I built for this type of renders. And if you're interested in learning more about this material, I'm going to put a link to a previous tutorial where I cover how to use this material, which is free, and you can download it from the description of that video as well. All right, so if I go ahead and turn on this S4 shader, and you'll see that this is the outline that I get. And it's pretty decent outline, and it's something that comes from the material. But if I turn it off and I don't have anything else, it's hard to kind of like see the silhouette of the model. That's why I created this outline, which I'm going to show you how to recreate. And it's an outline that has nothing to do with the material, right? So what's cool about this is that I can switch to another material, let's say basic gray, or even the skin shade 4, and just give it a green color. And this is a material from ZBrush, but it's using that outline. So the theory behind this is actually really simple. Let me show you what that means. If I open my subtool palette, I have, let me go into solo mode as well. I have my base model, right? And then I have a duplicate that is giving me that silhouette, and it's the same model, slightly inflated, and I inverted the normals. So you can do this with any model that you have. You can duplicate it, inflate it a little bit, and then flip the normals so that you can see through the model or inside the model. Right? So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to actually clone this so that we can start fresh. And yeah, we can work with this. Maybe let's give it a different color so that you can see what I'm doing. So I'm going to leave the RGB enabled, click on fill object so that we have color. These buttons right here, these switches for you should be at the top of the interface or under the draw palette. You have RGB material as well. We're going to be using that. So this is the base, right? This is the equivalent of any model that you would have. Now to make the outline, we can forget about the material now. We can duplicate that model or that subtool. So now we have two subtools living in the same space. And now I'm going to, because I'm in solo mode, I'm only seeing the second one. So I'm going to select a material. I should have not closed that. I'm going to select the matcap gorilla. So this one right here, it comes with ZBrush, and you can choose anything that you want. You can even give it a golden outline if you want, but the matcap gorilla is probably the best option right now because it is pretty dark, and if we select a black color, it's going to be pretty hard to distinguish any volumes. So first, with the RGB switch enabled, I want to click fill object. So now we filled it with this color, and now with the material enabled, fill object, now we have filled that gorilla or matcap gorilla to this object. So now we can switch to any other material. Let's go to skin shade 4 and white, and you'll see nothing changes because we basically fill that model or fill that subtool with a material and a color. So no matter which one you choose, it's going to stay the same, and that's what we want. All right, so to complete the trick, all we have to do is let's actually turn off the poly paint so that you can see what I'm going to do, and that is just from that icon right there. So the first thing I want to do is make sure that this double is disabled. And you can disable that from the tool palette if you go all the way to the bottom where it says display properties. Let me just collapse this. So this is what you should see. This is the same switch that I have in my UI, and the flip one is also as well in there, right? So the first thing is you want to make sure that this is disabled, and then you want to flip the normals. So when you flip the normals, basically, you can see inside the model, which is, it looks pretty ugly because you're looking at the normals pointing inwards on the model, right? So it looks pretty ugly, but that's what we need. So just stick with me. Right, so we have flipped the normals. If you leave the double on, it's going to look like normal. And that's why we want to make sure that double is disabled. This ugly looking mesh, this is what we need. All right, so now we can go back and toggle the poly paint on again, and let's get out of solo. And that basically give us the starting point for this outline. So just a quick recap, we have the basic model, and then we have the outline with all the tweaks that we just did for the flipping the normals and assigning the dark material as well as the polypane. So to achieve the outline, what we're going to do is with that outline mesh selected, let's, you know, just for the sake of keeping things organized, I'm going to rename it, call it outline, so that you know what I'm referring to. So that outline, let's go ahead and open up the deformation palette, and we can inflate or deflate this model from this slider right here. So let's click on this inflate. Usually, if you want to inflate or scale something up, you would go towards the right-hand side of this slider. But remember, because we flip the normals, we have to deflate it. So that, I know that this is a little bit counterintuitive, but just click on this slider and go into the negative values, and that would actually inflate that model. So you see, we can go like pretty thick or not. So I'm just going to keep something like this, very subtle, right? And no matter where I looked at this, we're going to have that nice outline. So that is basically the trick, right? You can just leave it as it is, and that is good enough, or you can go ahead and tweak it a little bit. So once you have the outline, we can do a couple of things. The first one is that I'm going to make this document double the size so that you don't see all the, you know, kind of like the artifacts of the empty alias. So I'm going to click on double in here, which for you guys would be under the document, double, click yes, control N to clear the canvas, click and drag, enter edit mode. So we're back. But now I'm going to click on the AA half, which if you have the standard UI should be on the right hand side, or as well in the document palette is this one right here. So now this is looking at half of the document, but because we made it double, we can just go a little bit closer, and you see it looks a lot cleaner in terms of the outline. Now, the next thing that I'm gonna do is, because this is a model or this is a mesh, we can do a lot of things. We can, with the move brush, we can literally increase the thickness of that outline just by pulling things like that, and it will stick with the model. You can do it from different angles, and that is pretty cool. Let me just undo that, right? And the other thing you can do is with the smooth brush, holding shift, you can smooth all these details that perhaps you don't want to have from this outline. All right, so I'm just going to do that relatively quick. So yeah, it's basically cleaning up the outline a little bit just with the smooth brush, and I think that works really well. And if you want to bring back all of those details from the actual shader, all we have to do is switch to the actual model, not the outline. So this is the original model. Select the comic style shade, and that's it. We have all those nice details. We can just try to replicate the same color for the background, so it looks kind of nice. But yeah, that's basically it. So now if we go into solo mode, because we don't have this other mesh interfering with us, we get only the details from the material, but we also have this outline, and we can go back to the outline and the move brush. And, you know, we can just destroy it completely just to make something different. I don't know. I think this is more about experimenting to see what sort of cool stuff you can create with this. But it's a very useful technique, and it's applicable to relatively any software, really. You can do the same thing in Blender, Maya, anything like that, just flipping the normals of the same object, inflating it a little bit, and applied a toon shader or shadeless shader, and then you achieve the same thing. But this is pretty much it. Hopefully this tip helps you, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.